access. Cameras. Nice.
All these angles.
I know,
like,
right?
Like, yeah, we're totally on a crowd shot right now. Oh, no. Yeah, still there.
Of course. Lissandra, Maokai already being banned out. Vitality, you are not playing the same composition again. Fnatic will not give you the opportunity. Ryze.
Poor Cabo Shard. What is he going to do right now? No more access to the Maokai.
We've heard Soaz's thoughts on it. Maybe Cabo. Cabo just as excited, potentially?
No, yeah. He's not a Maokai player. For people that know Cabo Shard, he likes trading. He's really good in 1v1 scenarios, too. So we'll maybe see something more proactive come out. And then maybe we see Mighty Bear go back to the Rek'Sai that he was locking in earlier yesterday and be the tank force to allow Cabo Shard to shine in a more damage-oriented matchup, especially with the Echo being off the board.
Karma also taken off. Really just a lot of engage tools taken away and so many power picks left open and available. Mighty Bear.
And this is it's a viable strategy here. If you're in a best of two and you need to adapt between picks and bans and you don't know quite sure where you lost it, you just ban out three comfort picks. You say, you know what, guys, at least show us three new different champions. Maybe even steal a fourth away on your rotation. Force the enemy team to adapt. Maybe you can find a weakness.
Of course, Echo, on the opposite side for Vitality, it's not target bans. They feel obligated to take the power off the table.
Mighty Bear, how good's your Nidalee, is Fnatic's asking here.
Does he want the Kindred? We saw him play pretty well with it in Game 2 yesterday. Braum, of course, for Yellow Star. May have gotten caught out once or twice, but still a great tool for the team.
Purely on meta, purely on patch, you expect Nidalee Lucian here to be picked up. Two very strong champions. Remember, this is a flex pick for Vitality.
You never know.
Well, he actually has played it in the top lane.
Yeah, I remember. That was an interesting experience of a game. Moving in, though. Mighty Bear keeping the priority on Kindred for personal comfort there.
Showed it gives Spirit Nidalee.
Spirit is a legend on this champion.
Tell us why.
Storied career. Nidalee jungle. His time in the LPL, where World Elite was pretty much a team entirely built around this man who could single-handedly carry games if you gave him champions like Rek'Sai when Rek'Sai was at her prime, or Nidalee when she was at hers. So,
yeah,
terrifying jungler to go up against, to give him such a comfort pick.
Yeah, different tune here for Fnatic. They said, you know what, this kind of slower early game, let's go at it again. Kalista Braum allows you also to play aggressive. If he makes some of these over-eager positional mistakes, or moves, or stuff that goes wrong, he can get pulled back by Fate's Call. Looking for an aggressive lane too. Definitely want to get that access to the enemy jungle with the Nidalee. Outpace the Kindred.
I think it's going to be much more explosive from Fnatic this time around. It's something we have to be aware of.
Yeah. Ironically, I would actually like the LeBlanc here, because you can pretty much expect Fnatic to pick it to fit their very early skirmish competition, similar to what Unicorns of Love did here earlier. So going for LeBlanc Bard here would be actually really nice. I would love this rotation for Vitality.
They're thinking about it, really taking their time, letting it count down. Some pretty big implications this one. May not have tanks. That's a lot of great ways to start fights. Waiting. Bated breath. We're just so close into it, but it looks like at the end of the day it will be the Thresh picked up for Kasing. The LeBlanc, though, coming in for Nuke Duck. You said it works well in the team comp, but Nuke Duck had a very disappointing performance on it yesterday.
Yeah, all jokes aside, it is peculiar that Kasing goes for Thresh over Bard. Trying to be as objective as I can, it does seem like a lot of people really prefer Bard and many other champions over Thresh, you know, across the world. Thresh very low on the totem pole in terms of champion priority. Kasing does play a mean Thresh, though.
Yeah, very talented on that champion. Kind of his namesake at the start of his career.
Yeah, definitely was.
Repeated nerfs, though, over the years will always be an acceptable support, I think, but will never be the jack of all trades, if you will.
I mean, he was at one point when he could Q flash and stuff. Also, you know, when a champion only gets nerfed, you know, he was maybe a tad overtuned. Back in the day with his old kit, you could play Thresh without his ultimate, and he probably would still be the best support out there.
Do you remember when Death Sentence used to have the bonus damage on it, too?
Oh, it's like, what do I max? I guess Q.
I mean, what do you pick? And I guess it's Zed here. I love this matchup.
Yeah.
LeBlanc versus Zed in the mid lane. This could not be a more explosive lane. And now the Gragas coming in as well. Top lane for Gamsu. A lot of mix-ups here on the side of Fnatic.
It's rough to play, though, because both these junglers could shift this entire matchup when they enter the fold. Especially Kindred's such an annoying jungler. There was this angry tweet somewhere. It's like, Range junglers, doesn't matter if you flash, you'll still take 80% of your health and damage, because if Zed shadows aggressively once, Kindred comes in with red buff, like, it's almost impossible to make it out of there. And to see if Nukeduck and Mighty Bear have that synergy already. Very newly formed squad here. Mighty Bear coming in with Police. Can they work together? Because it's paramount to get that, you know, chain down, then get Kindred to step in, and you can really win the matchup. Very snowballing matchup.
Overall, a lot more focus on the early game. Looks like 50 minutes was a little bit long, too long for both of these lineups, because they are looking to fight here in the early to mid game, and there's a lot of power on both sides. I think, really, bot lane is obviously insanely interesting, but mid lane has to be the focus, and where are Spirit and Mighty Bear going to put their focus? Can it even be anywhere else?
Yeah, do Fnatic really want to lane this, though? It's still a rough matchup. Lucian, Kalista is pretty even, usually, so you got to look at the supports to see how it kind of rounds out. And melee versus range is rough, especially if... Usually the way you win with Kalista Braum is that you can then get a stun on the AD carry, but now you have Lantern to reposition him, which allows him to use his dash aggressively as well, you know? So Lantern is technically something that could allow more aggression, despite being a very defensive spell. Also, Exhaust is really good against Kalista. Very predictable when she has to rend, also slower down, less stacks.
Very reliable in the end, as well as the Trundle power pick. Not really contested as much earlier there in the bans, and you can see coaches shaking hands, walking off the stage. It's time for the teams to play this game, and it's time for you to hop on over to Twitter. I think Fnatic are going to come out on top. Hashtag FNC win. Do you think Vitality can close this out 2-0? Hashtag VIT win. We're not going to get a 50-minute game, ladies and gentlemen.
Says who?
Ah, that's true. What
the
happened?
The answer is like me. I predicted it, and then you're like, God, you know? Come on, Simon. Have some confidence.
All right, me.
It was I.
It was I who predicted not a 50-minute game. Vitality versus Fnatic once again. They swap sides. They gear up for game two. And we get ready for some cheeky bants while this pause goes down.
Nope, just pure raw game analysis. It's a nice water bottle.
good setup for yourself there. What do you think his thought process was behind purchasing that particular one?
I don't think he purchased it. So, Kasing has some audio issues. Mm. Apparently, that's also why there's a person next to Kasing.
Ah.
Talking to Kasing.
Oh, helping him potentially with the audio issues.
Yes. Right. That is generally the flow of things here. Mm. Referee is now telling anybody else, this is what Kasing told me.
And the chain continues.
The chain continues. Goes all the way up to, you know...
President of Riot.
He's not sleeping right now. It's like, Brandon, get out of your bed. We have an audio issue on stage. It's like, fix it. Okay.
Approval. Hierarchy. These things are important.
Company structure. Of course, we are not like that within casters.
Yeah.
CFA, right? You join our team. Everybody is equal.
Everyone is equal.
Some people are just a little more equal than others.
Ah, yes. I've always loved your loose definition of equality, Crypto. Oh.
And his headset is gone. This is where we spoil everything to Kasing. Kasing,
how do you feel about Game of Thrones, buddy?
Yeah. Oh, poor people in Twitch chat right now.
I love how it's like, yeah, it's good now. Pass it back to Kasing.
Yeah, the magic guy put it on his head. It's like, okay, magic headset is back. Just need a little bit of good luck rub.
The power is in your hands now, Kasing. Of course, both teams eager to get this started.
We have some R's in chat. That is obviously an abbreviated ready. So that means both teams are ready. So hopefully we can dive back into this thrilling game. Actually excited for this early game. A lot of action here, some CC Rotter. There will be some CS as well. Surprise, surprise.
I would wonder what would be happening if there wasn't any... We could see the all-out level 1 fight.
I mean, there's been the opposite. There's been no fighting pure CS in the Froggen 1v1 versus Aphromoo at All-Stars. Zillion versus Zillion.
Thrilling.
Thrilling.
Truly compelling for them, of course. looking back into the game now.
Yeah.
We got excited once. We can get excited again for this one. Vitality versus Fnatic. It's game two. No more pauses. No more breaks. Just a lot of aggressive picks and a lot of potential for violence here in this mid lane.
Look for Yellow Star. He's really good at getting those, you know, first boss procured. Sing. Ooh.
Oh,
that's what I'm talking about, baby.
Oh, flash over the wall. You can't let that concussive blow stack it up.
Changes the dynamic of the bot lane, too, playing without a flash all of a sudden. Suddenly, you can't go for aggressive push early because the level 2 gank does punish you. War on Grump, get some information, go back. We could also delve into the Krugs versus Grump science, too, but I'll leave that for a different day.
Looks like the slow walk up to the top side of the map. I'm guessing a ward went down.
Yeah.
That's the thing. You know, as hard as our job is, it's made so much easier by having a larger audience. Because every time a ward goes down, we will know.
We will know.
One
temporary
less thing to
insanity
worry about.
Fuels the crowd. So yeah, we're definitely seeing Fnatic looking for a swap here. Mm. That's why their bot lane's in the middle of the lane.
They're spotted out, though. It looks
and
like they
guessing.
Went...
Oh, did they see them?
I think Vitality originally initiated the swamp Fnatic.
Okay, so now he's looking to match that. Interesting.
Yeah, they got sight on it.
Surprised, actually, that they want to do that. So they're confident in his ability.
They know Kasing doesn't have the flash.
Yeah, Kasing's just going to check, though.
Flash forward, moving, getting aggressive. Kasing has no escape tools left. Play, moving forward.
Run, Kasing!
Drops. Run for your life!
Just run to survive.
In. Police?
Heal him! Heal him, police!
Police says no.
No!
I'm a man of the law. Stack's not going to move forward, though. Kasing just going to walk away.
Stacks. Only one stun, of course. Two flashes blown, a heal and an exhaust. So, in terms of resource investment, how they lead. Push goes now to Rex and Yellow Star, though. And this matchup is very push dependent. A lot of matchups in the bot lane are push dependent. When you are down a range advantage on your support and you still manage to push, you eliminate the need for it. Suddenly playing aggressive.
You can see Gamsu, though, playing very much on the back foot already.
So we need to kind of figure out why Fnatic wants these standard lanes. Maybe they just didn't want Gamsu to fall behind at all, because I feel like putting Cornwall in the dumpster, making it weaker for him to split push later on, must be a viable threat. Would have been maybe slightly the better option. Maybe they were worried with the lane swap speed. Again, you know, really good speed here on the swap. Speedy swap.
Speedy swap.
That's a creep that went down. We didn't see it. The crowd went in for the collective moan, so that must have been a cannon. Thanks,
Crepo
crowd.
Looks up to the crowd like, I got it.
It's like somebody nod in the crowd. Yeah, okay, cool. Thanks, guys.
Pepevin clearing out what he can as LeBlanc just pushing in here. Nuke Duck missteps in the Vladimir lane, but maybe a little bit more comfortable here, especially in the early levels. Junglers just clearing on their respective sides. No huge moments of action quite yet. Some fancy footwork. From Nuke Jack
the blue suede shoes.
He's a really dancing man.
Rivington would say. Gamsu. Let's see. This is one. Can he do it?
Even the CS up.
Oh.
Ooh. Forgot about the AoE, buddy. This is not. This
that's is a. I'll do it in American terms.
Cut,
that's
cut
a C
the camera. Walk. Walk away.
Walk away from the lane. You have lost camera rights. Lead to farming. We're going back to the mid lane.
Things continue. The worst part is that all of these lanes look so slow, but at any moment, one of them can result in a kill. Instant, one misstep, because every lane has so much aggressive power.
Yellowstar Reckless looking to keep the wave at their tower just a little bit, forcing obviously Kasing and Police to play up front. Kasing down a flash. So the whole premise of a double range lane is that you can bully, but when you're this far up in your lane, Kasing has to play back with a lantern. Otherwise, if you go too far, you can get circled by the jungler. So he can't really make use of that harass potential. That's why this lane very often now goes into CS. Spirit has snuck in, though. Could be a cheeky gank here if Gamsu gets the Oscar for Actor. That's a pillar.
Pillar to check. Nice call coming in from Cabo. Mighty Bear walking away, too. No aggressive moves quite yet. Interestingly enough, Mighty Bear opting to get the Hunter's Potion. He just wants to farm. That's really interesting. Moving in. Lanes continue to remain even. We're really waiting for these level 6s.
Yeah, good minion wave management here from Fnatic overall. They block the 3 main range creeps at their tower. I think the wave will stack up. Then it bounces back, so you have enough creeps in there. Hang on, Fevin.
Oh, flash forward. Nuketech trying to turn this one around, hoping to even out the trade.
Ooh, that's bold.
Sidestep.
Nuketech goes back in. He would have died if that hit, so.
Gets both summoners in the end, though, and Fevin isn't going to get any kind of greater advantage, but Spirit. Just over the wall here. Mighty Bear. A lot of people around this mid lane.
That's big on level 6, though. Once Nuketech comes back into the lane, all he has to do is call Mighty Bear, and he has two chains at his disposal. One for each shadow.
What they want. The swap lanes remain relatively even. Kabo. Small CS lead. Gamsu not comfortable farming under that tower whatsoever. Reckless. The good wave control you talked about earlier, netting him. Small advantage at this stage, but once again, waiting for level 6, waiting for these junglers to get their first items. Really look to get aggressive.
Yeah, and he got a back in too, so Police and Kasing really want to push in his wave as quick as they can, get more items. That'll be the good part of the matchup, though. Once he bases, he can pick up a lot of these components for this ghost blade. Back in the day, you would get the BF Sword and have a really big trading window.
But now, I mean, you just
now it's a ghost blade, but it's a good thing about the ghost blade build is that you can back at any given time because you always build components, right? There's always something for you to pick up. Banner poke.
Yellow Star hooked up.
Not going to be too much because Police still has the base, so then Yellow Star will get his base off anyways.
Yeah. You can see Fnatic are very aware that they have the advantage right now, and they're pressing home. Maybe a little bit more.
Oh, yeah. That sound of Rom Q is actually, like, correlating in my mind with a missed skill shot. I miss it so often. It's like, of course it didn't hit.
It's a hard life.
It's a tough life.
For the winner's fight. Not quite as easy to land. Once again, keeping our eyes on the jungler.
Ready for any action to emerge at any given time.
That's the thing.
Step away from the banter. At any moment, Gamsu right here could suddenly get a full mana bar out of nowhere. Still not killed.
Okay, let's lower our expectations a little bit here. I think the top lane, bottom lane action is going to be pretty
exciting. This could be it. The vault.
Mighty Bear.
Mighty Bear. Looking for a room.
Wants to get something. Maybe a stack. Maybe an Infernal Drake.
Gently increase the pauses between viewers. Adding excitement.
Really slow things down.
The play-by-play caster kid. It's like, what do I do if the game's slow and I have nothing to talk about?
Just talk slower.
Speak slower. Maximize word utility.
Nuke-duck.
We see Spirit here out-farming Mighty Bear, though, and that is something that is innate to the matchup, but not to this extent. So we can definitely see that Spirit was taking away some camps while Mighty Bear was holding mid, for example. Yeah. Now stole away the red buff, too. And, yeah, he's kind of outpacing Mighty Bear in the jungle. Mighty Bear was looking so hard to punish that flash being down from Fevervin, but it drew him out of the jungle, and Spirit's playing his favorite style, which is 1v1 versus enemy jungle. Right now, Yellowstar is being the bait here.
Well, Spirit coming in, has the red buff, but burning down. Health bar's dropping. Hunt marked. He's looking to block, but has to be careful himself. Colin comes out to try to dissuade anything else, but more members of Vitality are on the way.
Reckless knew that gank probably wasn't going to result in a kill, so he opted for the CS.
So many members poised and ready to go in, but nothing gonna come of it quite yet. No one ready to commit, overcommit, too scared of losing the advantage. We talked about this. One kill, someone getting a small lead can change everything.
And both DPs are down too, and that is important too, because you will see the amount of action in the 2v2 is directly proportionate to teleport cooldown being up or down. Because you don't want to be that guy that goes in for the best trade of your life with a flash predict and then get TP'd on behind and you feed. It's actually one of the main reasons why we see bot lanes just going even so often, very rarely getting solo kills, because if you want to win a 2v2 matchup, you very often have to flash aggressively. You will expose yourself, but you will win the back end of that trade. But you can't do that versus teleport, because it takes you too long to kill the enemy, and you're just exposed.
So the bot lane may not be quite so aggressive if you hear those teleports. The bottom lane, with the top laners in it, of course, looking incredibly aggressive as Trundle just winning out all of these trades and the CS lead continuing to grow in the favor of Kabo Shard. And I feel like this is going to put some pressure down onto Fnatic. They're going to have to find a way to deal with this Trundle.
At the same time, though, we see the gold lead is on the side of Fnatic by a sizable amount. So despite Kabo being up, that means the remaining lineup is down overall for Vitality. And the largest part of that is in the jungle.
Mighty Bear really struggling here. Nearly 400 gold down just based on farm alone. Two stacks of Mark of the Kindred. Not terrible at this stage of the game, but not going to balance out that gold difference. You can see Nidalee already completing the Runic Echoes. Kindred still lagging behind on the Bloodrazor. Good news is that the value of the Bloodrazor is immediate. You don't have to wait for the Devourer stacks. A little bit weaker in the early game, though, as well. Spirit just continuing to take the jungle. Nice coming out. Here comes the all-in from Febiven in the mid lane. We hop away for just a second. Makes it that much better. Flash forward, snap back. Walking his way out of that one. Good avoidance there by Nuke Duck. Has to burn the flash, though.
Yeah. So he doesn't want to get hit by all those shurikens again. Summoner's down. Nuke Duck keeps his ignite. I like what Spirit's doing here. Making his presence known, and that's going to be a tower from the Ike. And this kind of, it's really the ripple effect of the nature of this jungle matchup. And then obviously, Spirit outpacing him. But I think it's also might be a fine trade to take here. One tower for an Infernal. If Fnatic can't use that gold advantage in the short term to snowball, Vitality may be okay with taking the trade.
Don't have to be decent. Oh, Spirit! We'll get a look at that in just a minute, but what a 1v1 we have to be sure. Confidence in that Nidalee play to go mid lane.
Yeah, so what likely happened is Nuke Duck saw Febiven back, wanted to push out the wave, used this. Dash is aggressively likely to get the wave and then got punished by just a jungler happening to be around.
Mighty Bear now trying to take a post in this mid lane. Febby, of course, no ult and no summoners.
Yeah, but just the damage in this turret. This is definitely making the entire trade worth it for Fnatic. As this tower falls, we're looking at a very large relative gold lead for Fnatic this early in the game.
8% scaling AD and AP, not enough to balance this out.
Yeah.
Make nothing different. Mighty Bear being aggressive. Cooldown's not up for Febby just yet. Not going to get the auto off there after that Dance of Arrows, so no third proc on the Mounting Dread. Febiven just continuing to push out, but Nuke Duck is returning to the lane. Making his presence known.
Yeah.
Nice. Goes over the wall as well.
Oh, that's a good pillar. Cabo Shard is here all of a sudden.
Deathmark not on cooldown.
Knock,
suddenly,
knock.
Cabo out of nowhere. A little Slugger Trundle. Making
yeah, well,
things
well hidden by the Observers, too.
Yeah.
You would expect like we would watch the minimap. We're so tunneled in on the action. So it was.
Now Vitality trying to get a greater advantage here. They may be down just a little bit in gold, but this tower would even things up. Doing the best to protect. Spirit ready to run forward. Yellowstar from the side. Nuke Duck. No Spirit is the biggest damage threat here.
Yeah, quite peculiar that Spirit didn't go for Gamsu didn't go for the ulti there. Could have knocked somebody into the tower, likely burned a summoner. Especially with the additional support coming in from Yellowstar on the flank. I feel like there was more in that play for Fnatic. Let's watch this.
Oh yeah.
So my entire theory is wrong. Nuke was just basing it. Yeah. That's just greedy.
Yep.
Yep.
Caught shopping.
Caught shopping.
Never where you want to be. And unfortunately, max range of spears do hurt. So, blue slate shoes, as Rube would say. Try to dodge that one out, but just
he was shopping for the shoes.
Shopping for the shoes. Couldn't find them. Finally gets them. Too little too late here. Fnatic taking down another tower. The tempo definitely in their favor. The gold following as well as they move up to 2K.
I mean, this is pretty large gold lead for the time of the game.
We saw 2K gold leads at 40 minutes in our previous game. A 2K gold lead at 13, a little bit bigger difference.
Yeah, look at Spears just kind of nibbling away at the enemy jungle resources, taking them all for himself. That's another spear. You can tell because Police's health bar is now half.
You can tell Nidalee's ahead because Police's health bar is now half, of course.
Power of deduction.
Crushing it, man. Moving forward, Nuke Duck not feeling nearly as comfortable.
Alright, when is Febiven gonna move to this side lane as well? Zed that's comfortable in the game usually ends up in the side lane. Reckless has cleared top lane, went bot lane, got that tower. Not yet is the mark for Fnatic, so just want him to get a little bit stronger here before they send him off.
Maybe hoping to finish up the Maw there before moving off to the side. Especially the Yomus. Does have to deal with the Trundle if he wants to go to the side lane. Could be tough. Trundle, of course, though, itemizing the MR. Zed as well, so neither one particularly well itemized against the other.
Yeah, Mighty Bear is not pathing that efficiently, very following behind, very much so in farm. So, Febiven, the early pressure he had has had a large mark on this game. He forced Mighty Bear to go mid, loses jungle, Spirit outpaced him, stole his red buff. Now he's doing blue buff. I think he's just going to take that for himself. I think he needs to.
I mean, continuing to move forward as well. Rod of Ages pieces coming in from Spirit, not even rushing to the Rylai's as we so often see. So far ahead that he's comfortable.
Yeah, he's holding it right now, wasting so much time. Look at what Spirit's doing right now. Just like, high enemy jungle's clear. Might be better as this Krux spawning now, but they're so far away in the map, so it's rough right now. Getting contested for vision. Yellowstar's moving in. That's a bit deep though, Yellowstar. Fate Scholar is luckily available for him.
Toss him out, toss him right back in. Vok stopping the advance there. Yellowstar slowed up for just a bit. Vok ready to come over the wall. Zed responding as well.
Yeah. That Fate Scholar pick is really, really good for Fnatic because Yellowstar has shown this tendency to go ham. We don't know it. If he's calculating in the fact that he has Fate's Call.
Or if he's just going in.
Or he's just going out and then discovering it mid-issue. It's like, I guess, yeah.
I've reevaluated the situation. I would now like to leave.
I would like to withdraw. Beam me up, Scotty.
Moving back, though, of course, Vitality. Still making moves to stay ahead in this game. Split push threat coming in from Kaba. Continuing to grow as he finishes up that Ravenous Hydra. No boots necessary. I'm just playing some PvE at the moment.
Are you equating Gamsu as a minion? It's a little harsh.
Wow. Wait to spit it that way, thank you.
I can't believe you said that, Sifa.
Krepo, PR master.
Yeah, clearly.
They've considered running for office. Moving in, I mean, of course, game still relatively even. Fnatic maintaining their lead, looking to extend it to 3K as we push forward because Spirit continues to dominate the jungle. Rod of Age is well on the way. With Vitality, they're hungry for blood.
Yeah, police, sword collection. Yomus, three long swords. He's packing a lot of heat right now.
Moving in.
200 raw. Well. See the predict from Kasing.
Make his way out of here. Nice barrel to get them off of him, but I don't think it's going to be enough. Gongsu. The slow burn as Vitality grab another one, but Fnatic, they're hungry for the mid lane. They've got so much power here.
Can they block the calling here? Tongue's available. Yellowstar moves away. They still have enough minions.
They're still going to come ahead in the end. I feel like this is exactly what we saw from Origin in the Severus Unicorns of Love earlier today, trying to make proactive moves, but not being aware of what the potential cost could be. Spirit, though.
Forced off.
Definitely a lot of map movement. Spirit tracking down the enemy as the rest of Fnatic descending upon Vitality slowly but surely. Maybe we'll find the fight here. Nuke Duck hovering as well. It's a race to make it into this fight. Vitality ready to stand their ground. They have the Lamb's Respite. They need to stay grouped. Nuke Duck on the way. Police on the way, but Fnatic are going to get here sooner. Febivin not jumping in. Throws him in. Beam me up, Scotty. Yellowstar making his way on the front line. Cabo moving forward. Kasing, he's going to drop. Moving in, and Spirit and the rest of the team taking control. Cabo next on the list. Nuke Duck looking for the flank. I don't think he has enough damage to kill Spirit. It's not going to be there. Fnatic taking control.
Yeah, I really like the way Fnatic played out that fight. Yellowstar, really good overview. Gets connection on one. Doesn't go for the panic stun lock on Mighty Bear. Like, I have to make this move right now. Mighty Bear ended up not ulting, though. But then he tags Cabochard on the way out, slows him down enough for Gamzu to keep him busy, and then they manage to run him down. So this is Vitality getting kind of rotated.
And now very much in a deficit. 5k gold lead over to Fnatic. Dragon live for them to take if they want it, and the team owns the top side of the map. Spirit already owned this jungle. Now he's got the vision there to back him up as well, and Fnatic can take just about any fight they want.
Spirit's like, your jungle? My jungle.
My theory is that Spirit is colorblind and just always goes wherever he wants to go in the jungle and just assumes that it's always his.
Yeah. Fantastic theory. I don't have any proof to denounce it, therefore it must be true.
Ah, yes. Wondrous, isn't it? Moving in, though, Fnatic more than happy to have this Mountain Drake. They've already been burning through towers fast enough. Let's take a look at that play one more time.
Yeah, they're not committing until... Guys, seeing, look, there's this Q here and then the flash. Ulti from Yellowstar. Kind of wondering why Mighty Bear didn't pop his ulti. Probably just got more damage than he expected and was really trying to make the play as efficient as possible. Nuke Duck is
Goodbye.
Dead. That was indeed his corpse. You can also tell that he's dead because there's a red number ticking down on the right side.
His portrait is slightly darker than it normally is as well. Yeah. Do you write the tips that people see during the loading screen, by the way?
Some of them are slightly outdated. No, I do not, actually. I just cast.
How we expected more from Gamsu. Trying to get aggressive, but maybe bite off just a bit more than he can chew here in these exchanges. Jungle, no strange for that. Oh, quick blue buff pickup. Looks like it went over to Spirit in the end.
Yeah. Vitality still in mid lane, though.
Yep. Vitality really just struggling to hold on to anything. It's a slow choke out as Fnatic just continue to take advantages. They own the jungle.
Yeah, it's when you play two similar comps that are kind of pointed at the early game. I mean, the snowball, whoever gets the lead obviously has a lot easier game to play. Teams have gotten so good at closing out these early game advantages too, just taking away enemy resources, not tunneling our kills unless they result in a kind of tied in objectives, go for kill plus tower. The biggest man here for Vitality is Kabashar on that side lane. Maybe that's why Fevin is still playing the mid lane. Trying to fight Reckless for farm though, because as this game progresses, nobody really wants to be the guy on the side lane against LeBlanc, especially not a Kalista without her support. And without your support in the mid lane, it's hard to take full control of the map. So we'd like to see Fevin change lanes over to a side lane soon.
Does have the two items as well as the Boots of Swiftness. A very solid option to go in, but we're going to take a look at that 1v1. Oh, 2v1. Moves in, moves out, throws down some abilities. That was
dirty.
Super clean. Fevin, there's a reason why we get excited every time Fevin picks his head.
Yeah, that was actually out of nowhere. It's like, Nuketuck really has to be scared this game. Right now, getting collapsed on two.
Oh, Spear lands. That could be the death sentence they're looking for. Instant pop here. Fevin on a killing spree. Fnatic.
No room for Nuketuck in this game. Constantly getting challenged. Every move he makes, every mini wave he tries to get. Now more for Fevin.
Locked up. No death mark available quite yet. Is trying to run in. Runs back into the Lamb's Respite. Great play. It's going to pop. He's going to spin. Members are going to go down. Spirit grabs one. Fevin grabs the other. That's the rampage for the van in the mid.
Yeah, and it started with just a 2,000 gold lead at 30 minutes in the game, and spiraling out of control right now. Fnatic up 8,000 gold already and not looking to stop. They want more.
Crushing, moving forward. They've got the Fed in Italy. They've got Kalista to make sure that they can take this one safely. Everything going in the favor of Fnatic. This Baron, just a product of the massive lead that they've accrued.
Yeah, definitely. So Fnatic will definitely, they're going to win this game. We almost have to call it out with this. So we need to judge them on execution right now.
Yeah.
See how well all the closing machine is for Fnatic. They have all the tools they need. Vitality drafting a similar composition in the sense that their wave clear is very lacking. Nuketuck was out of options. All Gackles is used. The mistake's already made. The fact that you were in a position overextended and you have no cross maps. Like, it's fine to be this far out with a LeBlanc. The problem is, if you play these compositions, usually you have something to punish your team for trying to hunt you down with four or five members, and you can buy so much time. But there was nothing. Vitality was too far back on the map, so Nuketuck was just simply overextending.
Cannot afford to make those mistakes when you're already behind. You're talking about, he just doesn't have space to play on the map. And Fnatic, they're not just looking for kills. Every time they get the opportunity, they go in. Fevin,
pop, pop.
Can't say it better myself. Just gets the fadeaway kill there. Almost disrespectful, the confidence he has. But that one's going to work out. And now, they've taken down the Mighty Bear. They're moving down to bottom lane.
The Mighty Bear?
The Mighty Bear.
The Reckless and the Yellow Star.
The spirit of Fnatic. Moving forward, though, Vitality, I mean, this is just...
This is a slaughter.
Yeah.
Out of all things considered, though, tying against the Fnatic as Vitality has to be, I think, a result they would sign for starting the week.
And we have to remember that they still have so many new pieces, whereas Yellowstar, yeah, technically, he spent some time away from the roster, and maybe they have to get back into the swing of things. But this is the team that should feel pretty comfortable playing together.
Yeah, they're playing at least from the same set of puzzle pieces. Like, oh yeah, this piece, we've used this before, we can put it back in there.
Yeah.
It's like, for Vitality...
They're a kid with a
knife.
They've
got,
cutting them into shape.
Cutting them into shape, but they're playing with three boxes, you know? And you mix your puzzles.
Yeah. We'll figure out which puzzle they finish to move through the season, but right now, things not quite perfect, although an impressive game one performance. Fnatic absolutely dominating here in game two.
Who's going down next here?
Oh, Spirit. Fevin picks a target, he points, he clicks, he throws some shots, but it's not gonna be enough. Good movement.
Goes in.
Moving forward. Yellow Star, they're going to find the stun. Two go down. It's the trade back and forth. The police dropping as well. Nuke Duck jumps back in. What goes down? That's a disaster. Fnatic, they're going to even up the set 1-1. And what we can safely say is the most one-sided victory we have seen this season. Absolutely an insane performance, and one that Fnatic can be proud of, closing out the week with 4 points. The 2-0 yesterday, 1-1 today. These guys have to be feeling happy.
I mean, we're about to find out.
Maybe. Should we play the play? Takes off the headset.
Steps away from the chair, moves chair back before getting up.
Oh, headset, position. Headset. They're dropping. Players standing.
Let's
okay.
see, do they opt in for the handshake or the hug? Hybrid.
Supporting him.
They're not that happy.
Yeah.
4 out of 10. It's like judging synchronized diving, you know, you gotta aim for the details. Yeah, the series ties up here.
1-1 overall, and looking forward, I think Fnatic have to be pretty happy to come back confidently in that exchange overall.
Finally get
We're
my
handshake. Shake the player's hands. You probably, oh, you can't see this on camera. Thank you, camera. That's good. It's good. Good game, boys.
It's the closest I get back to being on the stage. I can't go for the handshake myself anymore, like, but I can shake them.
If I touch your hand, it's like I played League of Legends competitively again. Yeah.
Yes, Challenger. I will never wash this hand again.
No. Mitch Krupp of War School is a super fan.
Yeah. Oh, no. Please.
But of course,
I'll take all these guys on board. I have already.
They just ban it, I think. They get 3 bans, Krupp. You're going to need to deepen your champion pool.
There's no room for that anymore. One trick or bust. Anyways, good series here.
Yep,
100%. Pretty convincing victory of Fnatic. Similar styles come out. For me, 2 players really to control the game. Spirit and Febiboon. But
absolutely.
I think it was still Febiboon with his early trades here, forcing Nuke Duck out of the lane. Yes, he didn't get anything. He then managed to still play aggressive while being down in summoners. And it was the chain reaction, the ripple effect. Mighty Bear was forced to kind of sit around the mid lane, pick up some of that CS, and then Spirit took that opportunity and took away all the jungle from Mighty Bear. He then snowballed that, and then Fnatic as a team closed out the series. Reckless consistently playing well, safe on the side lanes, taking all these towers. So as a unit, Fnatic definitely performed.
I think so overall. I mean, Gamsu taking a weaker lane phase overall, but working out for the team as a whole, you know, making that sacrifice, giving up that pressure so that it can be placed elsewhere. And this looks like an excellent start for the team as a whole.
Yeah. Like Manager Quay on stage there too. Together with Daylor, they still have things to work on.
Absolutely. Fnatic. And as do Vitality, but I think for week one, to start up with some changes on the rosters on both sides, both teams can be reasonably happy walking away with 4 points.
Yeah,
four,
and
2 points for Vitality.
2 points for Vitality, 4 for Fnatic. Fnatic was also the team that was closer to winning this series. Mm-hmm. I mean, a very close game one and an absolute blowout in game two. Vitality, they need to find some consistency because they had the same thing happen to them kind of game day one. I need to see what they bring out next week. Obviously need some time. They obviously have 4 games under their belt. That is the benefit of the best of two system as opposed to just the mere 2 they would have had last season.
And one thing that we know for sure is that when they have Lissandra, when they have these picks where they can force fights on their terms, they are an incredibly strong roster. But we have to look forward for them and wonder what else can they bring to the table as the 6-10 meta evolves moving forward, and if people just continue to ban this Lissandra away from Nuke Duck, what they're really going to opt for, because the LeBlanc, despite 2 poor performances,
it's not working out here. But it's still correlation, causation, you know, is it just Nuke Duck's LeBlanc, or is it the framework he is put in? What we can kind of conclude is that 6.10 is, for me, an exciting meta.
Yep.
Gone are the days of just the tanks in the top lane. There is different priorities for different teams. Like, some teams are still playing Swain, for example. We now see much more diversity in the mid lane too. It's no longer just Azir and Ryze. I mean, Ryze is still the
must ban.
He's like the
right?
Alistar of worlds, like the permabans. Like, get him out, and then we can maybe start talking about champions. But like we've seen Lissandra, Ryze, not Ryze then. Lissandra, Zed, LeBlanc. We've seen maybe some Swain being played. Vladimir, Victor is back. Seen some really cool Victor. I mean, and it's really fun to see the slightly tweaked Victor played by a phenomenal player.
Yeah,
I had Yeah, the fortune to be carried by Fox, who's clearly in wrong elo on the game of Victor, and things he did with that champion makes me excited to see more of a lot of these mid laners here in the ULCS.
Yeah, and the performance we saw from him yesterday was really exciting as well. And Zed coming out, LeBlanc, aggressive assassin picks, Fizz in the mid lane for perks yesterday. Yep. Control mages, you've got a great engage options, interesting top lane picks, both in terms of tanks and in damage. Bot lane, as Mythy said yesterday, no meta. But one man who's no stranger to picks in the meta, one man who's always happy to use Nidalee, is standing by with Pyrotechnic on the side. So we're going to toss it over to him and see what he has to say.
Thank you very much, Sif. I'm joined by the jungler for Fnatic Spirit. Congratulations on your win. You drew the series at 1-1, and those games couldn't have been more different. What changed within the team that made you want to go for this really aggressive start in Game 2 with all the assassins and you jumping in crazy on the Nidalee versus in Game 1?
We changed play style. First game, I think we are too scared. We just afraid enemy double TP. Lissandra have TP. We got TP flank is kind of doomed. So we don't want to do this. So we just play safe. But I think this playing is really bad. It was, I don't want to remember.
Well, game two certainly looked a lot cleaner from you guys and a lot more decisive. It was really, really crazy between you and Febiven running around on the map. But you got your hands on Nidalee finally. You've been playing Lee Sin the rest of the split. With Kindred Nidalee pretty much being first pick banned all the time, what do you make of the jungle priority right now? And do you agree with what everyone thinks is strong?
I think now jungle is important thing is need a 2v2 or 3v3 strong pick, I think. So Nidalee is really best jungle speed. So he can do whatever he wants, you know. But Kindred is really strong at gank. Yes.
Well, they clearly agree with you on that one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I think tier one is Kindred and Nidalee, and the second is whatever, yeah.
Fair enough. So pretty much what everyone agrees with. I want to ask you a little bit about your jungling opponent, too. Mighty Bear, another Korean coming into the European LCS. You've only gotten to play against him today. What do you make of him as a player? Do you think he's very strong? He's been hyped up a lot.
I'm not sure now because he must have communication issue, maybe, because he's Korean. He went to Europe just 2 weeks or something, yeah. Because first week is a split. Spring split, I have same issue, communication issue, so maybe, yeah, I'm not sure about him.
Well, you certainly have, looks like you guys and your communication is really, really firmed up. How much of that is on Yellowstar, by the way? How is it playing with the old and now new Fnatic support?
Actually now, it's really stable for me because I can just do my job. But before, for me, I need to care about so many things, yeah.
So it's a lot easier.
No, I really love it, actually. Sorry, Clay, my bad.
Well, I'm sure he forgives you. It's nice to see that you guys are having a little bit more easier of a time jiving. For that, though, we are going to go ahead and send it back to the analyst desk to break down the 1-1 on the day for Fnatic and Vitality. Take it away.
Thank you, Pyra. Oh, I love interviews with Spirit. He always just speaks his mind. Obviously, he didn't mean anything bad with that. He just means that Yellowstar is bringing stability to the team, something that, of course, we were thinking about, but we had no proof of it. But it seems that role of him, that shot calling now, is fixing a lot of the things that they wanted to work on.
Yeah, the return of Yellowstar is really great to see. I do like having him back. I was curious as to how much of an impact he would have, and just based on what Spirit said, it's like, oh, it's so much easier now. I can just do my job. Everyone can just fit into their roles comfortably, and we saw that a lot more in their game. Febiven on the Zed. We saw Reckless on the Kalista. He brought it out yesterday, and he had a great game on it today. Gamsu on the Gragas, another interesting top lane that we're seeing more of. It's really nice to see Fnatic being back to what they used to be.
Yeah, what do you make of that? The fact that, of course, we saw Zac for Gamsu in game one, then the Gragas, not the things that most people are going for now. Obviously, Gragas is a viable top lane pick, but why do you think he's playing around with that?
Well, right now, Maokai, Ekko, and Trundle seem to be the triage of top laners. So when you take those out of the equation, you have to wonder, well, what are we going to next? And Fnatic are being like, well, there's a bunch of stuff we can play. Zac, we have the engages. He's a little bit weird with the teleport engages, because once you teleport in from the flank, you then kind of have to slingshot, and it's a little bit weird, but you have that engage potential. Gragas is a little bit more reliable, but Fnatic seem to just not afraid to pick out these interesting picks and varying up their playstyles.
Yeah, very interesting. Of course, our eyes were on the mid lane. You brought it up. What if we see the LeBlanc again from Yuukdok? And so it happened. Febiven on his signature Zed. How much did that matchup, do you think, determine the outcome of the match?
Well, it seems to be that Fidelity tend to live or die by Yuukdok. And right now, the fact that he played that LeBlanc, he couldn't get the impact that he really wanted up against the Zed, I think hurt Vitality because they were trying to make plays around the map. They were looking for picks, and they just couldn't quite find them. It wasn't the same Vitality that we saw in game one. And the Zed into LeBlanc matchup is typically a skill matchup, but the problem for the LeBlanc is if you don't get ahead during the laning phase, you are forced into his Zhonya's, and that is not the ideal build path you want to be going on a LeBlanc, so your impact in the mid-game tends to fall off, whereas with the new Black Cleaver, because of how cost-efficient it is, it's actually really efficient on the Zed. So the longer the game goes where it's even, Zed slowly starts to pull ahead, and then you get that fantastic outplay, the 1v1 with Febiven against Yuukdok to just solidify their victory, and once that had happened, you just know, yeah, well, Nukeduck's donezo. There's nothing else he's going to be able to do in this game moving forward.
And with that, Yuukdok was player of the game in game one. Febiven is player of the game for us in this one. You know, it's one thing to pick that champion, but he played well on it. The entire team played well around it, and so he is our player of the game. I do want to touch on Vitality. As we say, you say live or die by Yuukdok. So we need to take a look at what else has changed on that lineup, and obviously that is jungle and the AD player, Police. What have you seen from them so far?
So Police has just been solid. I feel like he's not overperforming, but he's not underperforming. Mm-hmm. He's not someone that is resulting in the team losing, but then he's also not being that standout carry. So Police, he's just kind of filling his role as just kind of like the AD carry that does the damage, kind of what he needs to be. But Vitality with Hyannon, when you think back to Hyannon playing a lot of Sivir, playing very much around these team fights, I feel like they're still getting used to that change in dynamic. They're still taking their time adapting to Police, and the synergy between Police and Kasing is something that's still growing. Mighty Bear, maybe a couple communication issues. I mean, his English isn't awful, but I think he is still fitting into a new team that has quite a lot of weight on them. Vitality were considered a top contender. They are still considered a top contender in this summer split. So I think that, as Spirit said, he had a couple issues integrating and communicating at the start, but it got better over time. And I think it's the same case for Mighty Bear.
Yeah, actually, I think we can see some similar storylines for both Fnatic and Vitality. If then not the fact that Yellowstar is, of course, kind of slotting right into that lineup, as he said in an interview also yesterday. They ended on 1-1, and as for an update on what happened over in the LCS arena, G2 has earned their second 2-0 of the week after shutting out Giants. Well, we kept an eye on that matchup as well. Fizz was going off, Kiki's Fizz, in two of those games, and Giants did put up somewhat of a fight, especially in game two.
In the early game, things were going pretty well for Giants, but that was about the only good thing that was going on for Giants. Moving forward, it was just very much G2 demonstrating their performance, showing you why they were the spring season champions. And when you acquired that insanely powerful bot lane in Sven and Mythi, it's simply a matter of, if we just do our thing and Giants, you do your thing, then it's just going to be a slow bleed out for G2. So just another standard day, another day in the office for G2.
Another day in the office, and 4-0 on the two first days.
Yeah, great way to start.
Yeah, can't start any better. Rather, well, that is it for the competition here in the studio. We are going to tune into EU LCS 1, where H2K and Shalkanulfia are taking to the stage. We'll catch up with you later today.